Welcome everyone, my name is Brendan Snyder. Thank you for joining me. So at this time of year, I like to do, countdowns and best of reviews of all the things that came out during the year. This one in particular, we are gonna do a sort of countdown of the best box sets of 2020. You know, if you're looking for something to get your significant other or a family member or somebody, for Christmas, box sets are always a great way to go. You know, with how bad 2020 was with its COVID, the upheaval, all the different stuff, the infighting through the election, that kind of stuff, music really came out on top. We got some amazing releases this year and a lot to dive in. As I said, there's 10, but before we go any further, if you are new to my channel and you haven't already hit the subscribe button, please click the button for me. Also leave a comment, hit like. All those things help support my channel, and of course, as an added bonus, you'll stay up to date on all that's going on in the world of music, just like this, where we are gonna talk about 10 of the best box sets from 2020. All of these have reviews, separate reviews on my channel. I will put a link to each one in the description below this video here if you wanna go check out more information on each one of these. So these aren't unboxings, I'm just giving you overviews here. All right, we're gonna do this also by release, so it's not so much countdown from 10 to 1 as it is the releases as they came out throughout the year. First one up, we've got Depeche Mode, simply called Mode. It is an 18-disc box set. You can see that it had cool glossy embossing on the box and stuff that comes out in the light. But cool box, and just so you get an idea of what was inside it, there's the contents laid out from it. So as I said, 18-disc box set. It includes their 14 studio albums. So if you own all of those, it is remastered. But what is really cool about this box set are four discs, the four added discs that make it the 18. It's got 63 non-album rarities and B-sides that span their whole career, 1981 to 2017. So disc 15 in here is 1981 to 1985. It's got 20 tracks. Then disc 16 covers 1986 to 1990. It's got 17 tracks. Disc 17, 1993 to 2005, and it's got 15 tracks. And then disc 18, 2006 to 2017, it's got 11 tracks on it. There's also a 228-page book in here that's really quite nice. All right, next up, we had Def Leppard. This one here, March 20th, the early years. Here's the backside so you can see, sort of contents and stuff, and it was a book style in a slipcase type packaging here. And this one here contained the first two albums, so On Through the Night, 1980, and High and Dry, 1981. So, if you do have those, that is a duplicate in this. It also came with When the Walls Come Tumbling Down, which was a live album from 1980, and a disc in here called Too Many Jitterbugs, which is a rarities collection. That one alone is worth it. And one called Raw, which is early BBC recordings, which also very good. It's those two discs in here that I think really make this. And of course, it came with a book as well. Now, interestingly, only a couple months later, on May 29th, Def Leppard put out another box set called London to Vegas. This one is four CDs, not much to see on the backside there, but packaging same as the other slipcase book style packaging. It's a four CD, two Blu-ray. It's got two different live shows on it. There's a London show, which they performed Hysteria in its entirety at the O2. It also has five additional live track performances as part of that show. And then the other show is Las Vegas. It's called Hits Vegas. And it's, of course, what it sounds like, a hits-packed show with some really cool deep cuts like Die Hard the Hunter is on it. 28-song track listing, and there's a four-song acoustic segment right in the middle of the show that's worth checking out. Okay, next up was Iggy Pop, and he put out a box set. This one here simply called The Bowie Years, and as it mentions there, focuses on the Bowie era that he, and of course David Bowie, took part in. It's a seven CD box. It contains a 40-page hardcover book. The discs in it covered The Idiot from 1977 and Lust for Life 1977. So of course those would be duplicates, and then TVI Live, which was 1978, that's been out of print for a long time, so it is nice to get that back here. Then there was a disc called Edits and Outtakes, and that's the one that was worth something here. 9 tracks, there's also an interview on that. And then there's 3 live concerts that are included. Rainbow Theater, London, 1977, the Angora Ballroom, 1977, and Mantra Studios, Chicago, 1977. So pretty cool stuff there. Some outtakes, some rarities, and some live stuff. Okay, next up we got Paul McCartney, and he did a deluxe edition for Flaming Pie. This came out July 31st. It's on all fabric packaging here, and it pops up and opens like that on it, and all the content is laid out on the inside. So this one here was a limited numbered edition. It featured 32 bonus tracks on it, 5 CDs, 2 DVDs that it's spread out over. CD one in here is the original 14-track album remastered. CD two is home recordings, which is really cool. Then disc three gets into demos, acoustic, and rough mixes of tracks. And CD four has non-album singles and the Ubu Jubu radio series included on it. Those were coming out as B-sides on the CD singles back in the day. It's nice to get them all grouped together. Then CD five in here is Flaming Pie at the Mill. It's an hour-long tour of his studio, and it doesn't sound like it'd be that interesting over CD, not hearing something, but it's actually really cool. He picks up instruments and dabbles on them and explains what songs they came from or performances they were used on, so that's pretty cool like that. Then you get 2 DVDs. DVD one is In the World Tonight, the documentary, which is really great. If you've never seen it, do check it out. And then DV2, which collects music videos and interview segments and things like that. There's also a 128-page book with unpublished photos by Linda McCartney in it, a lyric book. This next part I really like. It's a reproduction of John Hamill's studio notebook, and it's actually got reprints of photographs that he took of recording instruments that he wanted to use on certain tracks that are in it. And then there's, of course, replica memorabilia, as he always includes in these, a guitar pick, the Club Sandwich magazine. Then there's the Flame newspaper and handwritten lyrics for 8 of the tracks included in here. So a lot of really cool stuff all packaged into that box set, making it really worthwhile if you're a Beatles or Paul McCartney fan there. Okay, next up was The Doors, Morrison Hotel 50th anniversary. This one came out on October 9th, and in particular, this one here, so it was their 5th studio album at the time that came out in 1970, but this is not just a remaster on this one. This one here has the original intended stereo mixes that have been done newly for this, so they went back to the original mastering EQ sheets that they weren't able to achieve at the time, and due to technology now they could actually do it. So these had been, the original ones had been altered for the mastering of vinyl at the time. They've been restored, so that right in and of itself is really, really good. Some of the track speeds were off with it. Those have now been fixed, and to me it just sounds really new, really fresh, very punchy. It's very upfront, which I like within this mix here. The other great thing about this is that it's got a Mysterious Union, which is basically comprised of sessions for 2 songs, Queen of the Highway and Roadhouse Blues, and it's sort of like a fly on the wall moment, getting to be inside the studio, hear the studio banter between them, and then the development of each track, because there is a take, you know, this take and then another take and another take that moves them through, but the whole thing is seamless the way it's mixed. And again, I didn't think it'd be interesting hearing repeats of the same tracks done in the studio, but there's so much different development and take from each one to the other that it was actually a really fascinating listen, and I highly recommend it. Track 5 in particular on here, Queen of the Highway, take number 14, was actually recorded without Robbie Krieger at the time. But today, he went back in and actually added lead guitar work to that. So it's like getting new doors when you get something like that. There's also a couple of really cool cover songs on here. Track 12, Money, That's What I Want, and track 13, Rock Me Baby. So again, some cool unreleased stuff in that regard there. Next up, October 9th, The Replacements, Pleased to Meet Me. This one here, very cool. It's got the album remaster, but it's also got B-sides, demos, outtakes, and rough mixes that spread across 3 CDs, 55 tracks total, What's cool about it is it includes the BlackBerry Way demo sessions that featured some of the last recordings by Bob Stinson when he was still in the band. There's also one LP as part of this box set, but what's cool is it's not just the reproduction of the album itself. They decided to do the rough mixes on the vinyl. So if you've already owned the vinyl of the album, don't worry, you're getting something extra within this here. Okay, next up, October 16th, Tom Petty, Wildflowers and All the Rest, you know, the fantastic 1994 studio album that he did. This one here was originally intended to be a double album, and so it has been fleshed out finally. And this deluxe edition, which is a four-disc version, 54 tracks, 7 unreleased songs on here. Disc one, Wildflowers, the original 15-track studio album, has been remastered. Disc two, which is called All the Rest, that was what would have made up the double album. The 10 remaining tracks of studio recordings are on there. They were actually picked by Tom Petty prior to his death, so this is a selection of what he believed the original double album would have been. Disc three is home recordings. They are an intimate alternate take on the album tracks, which is cool. Disc four, Wildflowers Live. Really great inspired performances that don't always follow the blueprint. So again, a nice way to get these. They're not just a bunch of studio, home demo, live recordings that repeat themselves. They're all different. And so it's actually really interesting to listen to all these different discs in here. And then besides the four disc version of this that was like this in a book style, then they actually put out this one here, an actual like real box set, the lift top like this. This was a web only release, and it is a 5-disc version of it. This one here in particular had the 5th disc being called Finding Wildflowers, and they're alternate versions of the songs from Wildflowers as they were in development. So you get to hear the different takes of those, you know, a slower version or a more jammy version or a more rocked up version, or the drums are more up front in this one, where he was trying to figure out the style for each of these tracks. And again, really great listen to hear it. 16 tracks total. Two of the songs on there didn't make the album, so that's where the additional two unreleased tracks for the added, you know, this one here, 5 discs, 70 tracks, 9 unreleased on it. But as I said, web only, so you got to go to the website to order that if you're looking for it. Okay, then we got a really great one here. This one here, massive Thin Lizzy box set. There's all the stuff on the back side. This one lifts off, you know, traditional old school box style like that. It's called Rock Legends. And the box set covers their entire career and includes each album lineup as well on here. So again, when it covers the whole career, it really covers all the different lineups and members. 6 CDs, 1 DVD. There are 99 tracks across the 6 CDs. 74 of these tracks have never been released, and 83 of these tracks are making their debut onto CD here. So disc one is a greatest hits, but it's got single mixes, 7-inch versions, edits, and remixes for those tracks. Disc two is called The Early Years. It's got rough mixes, single edits, demos, B-sides, and radio sessions. Disc three, four, and five is titled Rarities. They've got alternate takes, demos, instrumental versions, and the quality of which is really good. So these are not like poor quality tape cassette versions found later and they're just, you know, scraping the bottom of the barrel. These are all really high quality versions. I just don't know why it's taken them this long to get this stuff out. And then disc six is the Chinatown Tour 1980. 15-track previously unreleased live show. And again, quality is really, really outstanding. It is not a bootleg at all. And disc seven DVD is called TV and Beyond. And it's got a Night on the Town TV special with performance in it. And it's also got the 1-hour BBC documentary called Bad Reputation, and again, is really outstanding. And then there's also memorabilia included. It's got a hardback book that collects all of the tour programs together into one book. Really, really cool way that they did that there. There's a book called Still in Love with You that's got quotes and stories from band members and people associated with the band, and also famous musicians and their stories and things like that from knowing the band. There's also a poetry book from Phil Lynott in here and 4 art prints. Okay, and then the final one, of the year is the YouTube box set, All That You Can't Leave Behind, 20th anniversary. Nothing really to see on here. It does slide out like this on here. But this one here features 5 CDs. Disc 1 is the remastered album. Disc 2 has B-sides, outtakes, alternate versions, 9 tracks total on it. Discs 3 and 4 are the Elevation Tour live from Boston, and it's an unreleased full-length concert, 19 tracks total. Disc 5 is remixes, of which there's 11 tracks, and 4 previously unreleased mixes are included within it. There's also a cool travelogue photo by Anton Corbin with comments as they were traveling around and shooting videos and things like that. So not just the same sort of photo books from in the studio and that kind of stuff. This one here is pretty unique to the way that they've done things in the past. And then there's a double-sided poster included. And there you go. That's, all the what I consider, the best box sets of 2020. Again, if you're looking for something from, for a Christmas gift or something like that, box sets are always a great way to go, picking out the favorite one for your loved one or significant other. Every one of these, all 10, have an individual review on my channel. And again, I will put the link in the description below. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Check back. I'm going to be doing, top 10 releases of 2020 and covering overviews of great albums and things like that that also came out. Those will come a little closer towards the end of the year because we're still waiting on a few more releases up right before Christmas. All right. Hope you all enjoyed this. Have a great day. Remember to leave comment, hit like, all that great stuff, and take care. Bye-bye.